This is Good Morning San Diego.
Teaching high school students how to save money. After the break, the executive director of Sensibility will be here to share a few tips on financial management. We'll be right back.
Money! Welcome back on this President's Day. A nonprofit organization is teaching high school students how to figure out their personal finance and manage money. Here to talk more about this is Sensibility Executive Director Roy Paul. Roy, nice to have you here.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Sense, C-E-N-T-S, ability. Ah. The one thing I didn't learn in high school, I'm always mad about this, is how to manage my money, how to manage the money that I was going to make eventually in life. And that's we're so behind in that area. Why?
Well, unfortunately, you're not alone. There are many states that do not mandate it. It's not a requirement to teach financial literacy, and that's part of the problem. That's why a lot of young people who aren't fortunate enough to win the lottery say to themselves, wait a second, I've graduated with college debt, don't know how to manage my paycheck, don't enter into a 401k plan. It just sort of spirals the longer you go in life.
But it's amazing that we don't even understand some of the basics of financial management. What writing a check, now of course a lot of people don't write checks anymore. We do everything either online with Venmo and credit cards and things right. like that. So that's also a danger because it's much more easy, it's a lot easier to navigate, but it can also be very confusing, and especially in the student loan area.
Right, and there's a generational gap with that, right? Because you still have a lot of young people who may not write checks, but their parents and their grandparents do. So they're learning some habits, good or bad. But some of the basics are, you're absolutely right, they're critical, and all of young people just don't know them. We're not having the conversations with them. So if you say to them, here's a credit card, Johnny, you know, fly with your wings, you'd be surprised what they put on it, right? Mm-hmm. I teach teenagers all the time, and they have $300 pair of sneakers on a credit card. I go, oh my God, who taught you that? Where'd you learn that? And it's just about managing what you want and what you can have. You know, if you don't have the cash, they feel the need, they have that piece of plastic to go and spend it, and that's not the best usage of it. So talking about the basics of credit card, okay. because it's tough, because you need it, right? Mm-hmm. You need credit. If you graduate from college, the first thing you're going to do is apply for an apartment. If you don't have credit, you're not getting anywhere right. unless you have a cosigner. So credit is a good thing. It's just about managing it the appropriate way. And credit cards are a great way to do that, but you just have to make sure that you put your needs and your wants and manage that aspect of it as well.
So let's start at the beginning.
Sure.
You leave school, and you start earning a living. So you start getting a paycheck. Mm-hmm. And the first thing you do with your paycheck is spend.
Right.
The first thing you should, according to what I'm hearing here from what you say in Sensibility, is save.
Save. Learning how to budget. The 50-30-20 rule, 50% of that check after taxes on the things you absolutely need, your rent, your car, mortgage, loans, or whatever you have. 30% on your, you know, wants, you know, going out for a vacation, going out to the movies. Mm-hmm. And then 20% save, you know, pay yourself first, as we like to call it. Right. And that's a very important lesson.
Why don't we do that?
We don't do it because we're not taught to do it. We don't talk about it. And a lot of people, 63% of the people in our program, they come from households that are low, moderate income. And so their families are, you know, they're relatively poor. So they're not talking about money. And if they are, they're having conversations like trying to pay the rent or putting food on the table. So there really isn't any extra cash to talk about going to Six Flags. Or, you know, that's not what they're talking about. So they learn these habits, unfortunately, from home.
How about learning how to budget? Because that's something I didn't learn until much later in my life.
Yeah, it's really money 101. If you don't know how to budget, then you're pretty much screwed for your life, I have to say it. And I talk to people all the time, and, you know, we have family members, and they're in their 60s. They can't retire. They will never be able to retire because they never saved anything. They never opted into a 401k plan. I have a cousin. I won't say his name on television.
I don't want to embarrass him.
But he worked at a company for 3 years and didn't know that his firm maxed out a contribution for his 401k plan. He didn't max out to the maximum. Wow. That's free money he just left on the table. Didn't take. Sure. So a lot of people are working at companies and they're fortunate to have benefits and they're just not opting into it.
So tell me about how you're doing this, your Sensibility program. You're going into schools and tell me how that process works and what the kids are learning.
Right. So we work with providers, host sites, whether they are nonprofit organizations, traditional public schools, charter schools, private schools. We have a hard time saying no. We just don't say that.
Yeah.
We have volunteers from the financial services industry, many of them working on Wall Street, and they want to give back, right? So we turn financial professionals professionals into educators. And they go into the schools and the nonprofit organizations and they teach, to, you know, we have 8 modules, everything from budgeting, savings, banking, up to, you know, the stock market, college planning. And we really give them a crash course in money. And by the end of it, we hope that they know some basic things. You know, one of my pet peeves is I talk to teenagers all the time and they're getting ready to go to college. We've done a great job in this country with maximizing the opportunities for kids to go to college. Nonprofits exist galore. In every state you live in,
right,
there's a nonprofit that'll help minority or poor people go to college. It's
right.
Great. But I say to them, when you take out those loans, and almost all of them inevitably do, I say, what's your monthly payment going to be when you graduate? Deer in the headlights. They can't answer the question.
Right.
And I said, you would never get a car loan and not know what your monthly payments are. No one would ever let you sign a mortgage without knowing what your monthly payments are. But for some reason, we find it comfortable to tell teenagers, go to college, 4 years, you can take out X amount of dollars.
Sure.
And we're not telling them when you graduate, you have to pay back this amount of money. So what happens? They graduate, they get that 6-month grace period, they get that bill, and they go, holy crap, I can't pay $800
well,
a month. Where am I going to get this from?
Yeah.
And some of them are not working. You know, it's great for those who graduate and they get 6-figure jobs, but that's not the vast majority of those who graduate.
Right.
You know, and they're stuck. They're trying to figure out how to make ends meet. And that's how they're starting their careers, right?
Yeah.
Forget 10, 15 years from now, they're not thinking about a mortgage payment. They're thinking about paying off their student loan debt. Mm-hmm. And so if you don't understand that very basic question, knowing what your monthly payment is going to be, and then working your way backwards. If you want to be in broadcast journalism, right? What's the average salary for a production assistant? You know, what's 20% of that? Can you afford to pay back that monthly loan? And then I say to them, because I get a lot of kids, they start doing the math and they go, oh my God, I can't afford to go to college. What am I going to do? And I say to them, no, you can't.
You just may not go to
the college you want to, right?
Right.
There's the private school that costs $60,000 a year, and then maybe there's San Diego State, right?
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong.
Community college,
and there's nothing wrong with that.
Oh, some really great tips. And if they want more information, go to Sensibility. We'll connect on KUSI.com to your website.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for being here, Roy Paul.
Thank
Pleasure
you.
To
and
meet
our
you.
Curriculum is free. Any schools in San Diego, if they want it, we'll give it to them for free.
Fantastic. That's great to know. Thanks
Thank
so
you.
Much for being here.
Yeah.